The vast majority of businesses in this city don't want help from the city, don't want programs that make it more conducive. They just want city government to stay out of the way so that they can do their jobs, hire the people they need, and sell the products or goods and services that they want. The vast majority of entrepreneurs probably don't even know that this discussion is taking place right now. So what we need to do at the city level is to reduce the burdens. Everybody says that reduce the burdens on small businesses, but we actually have to let them believe that by not sending inspectors out randomly so that it introduces unreasonable and unpredictable costs for our entrepreneurs. Our business owners know that the taxes and costs of doing businesses are high in the city of New York. But what they don't like is when they get hit out of the blue with unreasonable fees or fines or violations, when they think that they've done the right thing and that they've done the same thing they've been doing for 20 years, and all of a sudden they get these impossible to pay bills that in many cases drive the businesses out of business. My mom had a small store for a couple of years, and when I was in high school, I worked in that. And I saw the kinds of correspondence that we got from the city of New York. They were so difficult to understand. You would think that 20 years later, some of the changes would have been made. But yet, as I talk to entrepreneurs throughout the city, they're still getting the same kinds of notices. It's as if nothing's changed over the last several decades. So we have to change the mindset of government and see businesses actually as job creation engines and not just as cash cows to help reduce our budget deficits. And the other thing is that, you know, you talk about expanding the opportunity to grow and to create new businesses in the city of New York. Let's take a look, as I said before, at our economic development policies. We have to recognize that a tiny percentage of the businesses in this city get any kinds of subsidies from the city. And the subsidies are often large. They are often at taxpayers' expense. Why not, for example, try a crazy idea, get rid of all of these subsidies and reduce the business taxes for everybody across the board? That way we don't create unlevel playing fields even within our own city, where subsidized businesses are trying, where completely unsubsidized businesses have to continuously compete with their neighbors, some of them down the street, some of them a couple of miles away, that are getting significant subsidies from taxpayers. Let's level the playing field for everybody. And I think that actually works. You know, I think if you look at the economic and business outlook for this city, I actually, you know, there's probably a lot of perceptions about me in this room. I have spent most of my career in the business world, in corporations. Most of my career has not been in government. I'm new to government. It's been the last 11 years that I've served in office. And I pride myself on bringing my real world fiscal expertise to government, both in the controller's office and in my years in the city council. And I think that whoever leads this next city does have to have that very real world fiscal business perspective on how to grow jobs and expand economic opportunities in this city, and to do so in a way for everybody in this city, because that is the only way we're going to unleash the true potential of New York City.